Hello, everyone, and welcome into Coach Craig Sports. This is the NFL DFS video for week number 3. If you join me for the very first time, first of all, welcome in. Second of all, this is how this week's video will be structured. I'll be going through my player pool for both DraftKings and FanDuel, talking through the players that are listed here, a little bit on each player. If there is a certain player that you are interested in that's not in the player pool, don't freak out. You can still play them. If I have a quarterback here and I don't have like a receiving option of theirs, you can definitely stack them together as well. Same thing can be said about the wide receivers and tight ends if I don't have their quarterback listed at the same time. But without further ado, we'll get right into it with the DraftKings side. We're going to start off at the quarterback position with Lamar Jackson. $7,500 going against the Dallas Cowboys this week. Overall, that Cowboys defense has not been quite as good this season. Lamar Jackson does have that rushing upside, and the Cowboys have really struggled against the run early on this season, especially last week versus Alvin Kamara. Then we move down to CJ Stroud, $7,100 going against the Minnesota Vikings. Looks like a pretty favorable matchup here. Once again, obviously do love the upside of CJ Stroud and this Texans offense. Might be a little biased just being a Texans fan, but I definitely have to say that once again. Next up is Jared Goff at $6,500 going against the Arizona Cardinals. This was kind of expected to be one of the worst defenses in all of football, although it's been a little bit better so far. Like the upside of Jared Goff, you know, you compare him with Amon-Ra St. Brown. If you want to play Jameson Williams, you probably do that as well. Sam LaPorta has had a slow start to the season. A lot of different options we had there. Then we move down to Baker Mayfield, $6,300 going against the Denver Broncos. Probably a little bit more hit or miss defense. Obviously, when we talk about defenses, we've only had a small 2-week sample size, but Baker Mayfield's been awesome so far to start off the season. Definitely do kind of expect that to continue once again this week. Speaking of another quarterback that's been really good to start off the year, we got Derek Carr, $5,800. Been very, very solid so far. Really pushing the ball down the field. And, you know, the Eagles defense has had a little bit of holes so far to start off the young season. Then last but not least, we have Andy Dalton, only $4,800 going against the Las Vegas Raiders. Probably a little bit hit or miss in terms of defense. Obviously, Andy Dalton does have some pretty decent upside, and he is the starter this week with Bryce Young moving to the bench. We move over to the running back position. We got Saquon Barkley, really strong start to the season, goes against the New Orleans Saints, $7,700. You know, in past seasons, we didn't really want to play running backs against the Saints, but I remember a couple years back, Saquon Barkley dominated them, so I'm not really too afraid of that. He's off to a really strong start to the season as well. Opposite side of that game, you can go to Alvin Kamara, $7,500. Definitely do love his upside and the strong start to the season for him. Jonathan Taylor, off to a little bit slower to start, $7,300, goes against Chicago Bears. Should be a decent matchup there. And then we move down to Devon Achane at $7,000. Going against the Seattle Seahawks, no Raheem Mostert, most likely once again this week. He's listed as doubtful. So Achane is expected to carry the bulk of that workload once again with backup quarterback Skylar Thompson getting the start with Tua Tagovailoa listed on IR at this point in time. James Conner, $6,600. You know, solid veteran presence here. You know, he's probably not going to get too much ownership. Probably going to be in line with the field on him just overall. But going against Detroit, if this game goes back and forth, he does have a little bit of upside. Then we got Derrick Henry, $6,500. Like I mentioned earlier with the Dallas Cowboys, they have been unable to stop the run so far in this young season. Derrick Henry does have decent upside with that all being said. Then we move down to J.K. Dobbins. Really strong start to the year, $6,400 going against the Steelers. A little bit more of a tougher matchup than he's faced the first 2 weeks, but definitely do like his upside once again. Jordan Mason, still relatively cheap on the DraftKings side, $6,200 going against the Rams. You know, young nucleus there, especially in terms of that defensive line, linebacker unit. So should be a pretty interesting spot and a large workload for him once again. And then Zach Charbonnet is expected to be main back once again for the Seattle Seahawks this week. Do assume that Kenneth Walker is going to be out. I believe he's doubtful. He might be questionable. I'll have to take a look at that after this video. We'll leave that down in the comment section. But Charbonnet is going to be a guy that we are pretty interested in. Once again, he dominated the touches with no Kenneth Walker last week. Then DeAndre Swift was a guy that I did throw in here a little bit later, $5,600. Really slow start to the season, but goes against the Colts, who really struggled against their run last week against Green Bay. So if the Bears can run the football in this game, it's going to be pretty good for him overall. No Travis Homer, who's been kind of operating as the third down back. So DeAndre Swift could see a couple extra looks, especially on third downs. Chuba Hubbard, $5,200 against the Raiders. There is some upside to be had there. Kind of that main back once again for the Carolina Panthers. Probably not a guy I'm getting into too much of, but decent price tag altogether. And then last but not least, we have Cam Akers, $4,700, going against his former team in the Minnesota Vikings. Both Joe Mixon and Damian Pierce are out this week, so it could be some upside for Cam Akers just in general. We'll see if Dario Gumbawale, anybody else, gets into that backfield. Could be a little bit of a split situation, but would expect Akers is pretty popular at the cheaper price tag, but does have some upside versus the Minnesota Vikings this week overall. Then we move over to the wide receiver position. We got CeeDee Lamb at the top once again, $8,800 going against the Baltimore Ravens. Definitely do like his upside once again. Amon-Ra St. Brown behind him, $8,200 going against the Arizona Cardinals. Garrett Williams in the slot. Should be a pretty good matchup for him. Obviously, feel free to stack him and Jared Goff once again, as I did mention earlier. Marvin Harrison Jr. coming off a really strong performance, $7,400. I'm not too afraid of Tyrion Arnold if he ends up playing. He's dealing with an illness. Or Carlton Davis. So I do like that upside with Marvin Harrison Jr. once again. Probably going to be a little bit more popular this week, though, if we're being honest, since he is coming off that big game. He's got that big name and everything else like that. Nico Collins, really strong start to the season. $7,300, a really good matchup versus the Minnesota Vikings once again. Same thing can be said about Mike Evans. Pretty strong start to the season. It's a decent matchup versus the Denver Broncos. He could see a lot of Patrick Surtain the second in this game, which makes it a little bit less favorable, but I don't worry about too many corners when it does come to Mike Evans just because of the skill set that he does offer just in general. Devonta Smith, $6,900. No A.J. Brown. Should be a pretty good spot for him. A little bit of a tougher matchup going against the New Orleans Saints. Marshawn Lattimore, Paulson Adebo, both very good outside corners. Lattimore missed last week but is expected to return this week. Then we have Stephon Diggs, $6,600. Going against the Minnesota Vikings, another guy that we could stack with C.J. Stroud as well. Then we move down to Chris Godwin, $6,500. Off to a really strong start to the season. Going against the Denver Broncos, Jaquan McMillan in the slot. Should be a pretty favorable matchup for him. I believe McMillan's a little bit banged up too, so could ultimately end up being a backup slot corner as well, which would probably be even better for him. Cortland Sutton on the opposite side of the game, going against Tampa Bay. Relatively young, banged up secondary for them. Could be some upside there, although he's had a really slow start to the season. Rashid Shaheed has been really good to start off the season for the New Orleans Saints. $5,300 going against the Philadelphia Eagles. I believe Avante Maddox has been playing out of the slot, so should be a really favorable matchup for him. And then we got Tank Dell, $5,200 going against the Minnesota Vikings. Definitely do like that matchup once again. Pretty much any of these Texans wide receivers that you want to play are going to be viable on this slate overall. Get down to DeMarcus Robinson, $5,000. There's no Cooper Kupp. There's no Puka Nacua at this point in time. So DeMarcus Robinson, Tyler Johnson. You know, you're going to get to Jordan Whittington, Tutu Atwell. These guys are going to have some opportunities this week overall. Robinson's probably the favorite to kind of lead the way out of that pack. But wouldn't be surprised, you know, if Tyler Johnson gets in there as well. I can't remember what his price tag is. For some reason, I did not add him to the sheet. But if you want to play him, you can definitely do that as well. Then we move down to Deontay Johnson, $4,900, going against the Las Vegas Raiders. Looks like a pretty favorable matchup for him just in general. Going on the outside against those corners should be a good one for him. Plus, with Andy Dalton getting the start at quarterback, could help Deontay Johnson out quite a bit. And then last but not least, we have Jalen Naylor, who scored a touchdown both weeks to start the season. There is no Jordan Addison once again for this Minnesota team. Goes against the Houston Texans. I would expect that Derek Stingley, primarily going to shadow Justin Jefferson, so there could be opportunities for Jalen Naylor just in general. Then we get moved over to tight end position. Trey McBride, $6,200, going against the Lions. Should be a pretty interesting matchup there. Alex Alzone, their main linebacker, you know, predominantly good in coverage. He's a little bit banged up at this point in time. See whether or not he plays. I think he's questionable at this point in time. And then we got Sam Laporta, $6,000. Off to a slow start for the season, but good matchup versus the Arizona Cardinals this week overall. George Kittle, $5,700. Versus the Rams, should be a favorable matchup versus those young linebackers. And Troy Reader's not really young, but, you know, a guy that hasn't played too much in the past. And then Brock Bowers, $5,400. He's coming off a really strong performance. Goes against Carolina Panthers this week. Should be a pretty favorable matchup for him as well. Colby Parkinson, $3,600. Tougher matchup versus the 49ers, but with no Puka Nacua and with no Cooper Kupp, there should be some additional targets to go around just in general. Luke Schoonmaker, $3,300, going against the Baltimore Ravens. You know, if Jake Ferguson misses once again, I have not checked his status, so I'll keep that updated down in the comments as well. But Schoonmaker had a pretty strong performance last week. Going against the Ravens could be a decent matchup for him. And then last but not least, we have Jordan Akins. David Njoku is out once again. He's $3,000 going against the New York Giants. A little bit of upside there. Obviously did not pan out last week. And like I said, with Jordan Akins being a Texans fan, whenever you think you can count him, usually lets you down. Moving over to the defenses, got the Browns at $3,800. They're a pretty solid defense. They go against the Giants this week overall. If they can get pressure on Daniel Jones, should be a really good matchup for them just in general. Next up is the Chargers, $3,600. Going against the Pittsburgh Steelers, probably going to see Justin Fields getting the start once again. Russell Wilson's been limited in practice pretty much all week once again. So the Chargers defense has played relatively well to start off the season. This offensive line's pretty banged up for the Steelers team, so would not be surprised if the Chargers have another strong week. And then we move down to Seattle Seahawks, $3,500, going against the Miami Dolphins and backup quarterback Skylar Thompson. If they can get some pressure on him, could be a pretty good spot just in general. It's probably a team I'm not getting into too much of overall, though, just because, you know, you can hit a quick 10-yard route and Tyreek Hill takes it for a touchdown. So there is risk to be had there at the same time. Packers coming off a pretty strong performance, $3,300 going against the Titans. If they can get pressure on Will Levis, could be a really good spot for them just in general. Tampa Bay Buccaneers, another attractive matchup going against the Denver Broncos, rookie quarterback in Bo Nix. And they did recently place their right tackle, Mike McGlinchey, on IR. So a little bit of concerns with that offensive line at this point in time. On the opposite side of the Packers game, we got the Titans, $2,700. If they can get pressure on Malik Willis, who they probably know better than any other team, could be a good spot for them just in general. And then I do have the Bears listed here at $2,600 going against the Colts. You know, if Anthony Richardson throws like a pick or something like that, could be some upside to be had there. The Bears have a decent defense, and $2,600 is a pretty decent price tag overall. But with that being said, that's what I do have in terms of the DraftKings side. We'll get moved over to FanDuel and talk about my player pool over there as well. So on the FanDuel side, quarterback list here pretty much looks the same. We got Lamar Jackson, $8,800, going against the Dallas Cowboys. They've struggled against the run so far this season. The rushing upside of Lamar Jackson does look pretty attractive. CJ Stroud, $8,200, decent price tag, going against the Minnesota defense that, you know, we're not really sure what we're going to get out of them on any given week. Derek Carr off to a really strong start this season, $7,900. Going against the Eagles, that defense has not been the greatest through two games. So could be some upside with Derek Carr once again. Baker Mayfield coming off a really strong start to the season as well, $7,700. Going against the Broncos, kind of another hit or miss defense. We're not sure what we're going to get out of them on any given week. Then we have Jared Goff, $7,500. Going against the Arizona Cardinals, who were expected to be one of the worst defenses in all of the NFL. They've been a little bit better than we expected through 2 weeks, but still like the upside of Jared Goff and that offense around him. And then last but not least, we have a min price tag, Andy Dalton at $6,000, going against the Raiders. And there's a little bit of upside to be had there with Andy Dalton just in general. Moving over to the running back position, going to be pretty similar to what we saw in DraftKings. Saquon Barkley, $8,700, going against the New Orleans Saints. Like I said on DraftKings, last time I remember him playing against the Saints was that overtime game. He scored the game-winning touchdown. He had a really strong performance there. Saints typically been good against the run in recent seasons, but I do like the upside of Barkley and this Philadelphia team just in general. On the opposite side of the game, we got Alvin Kamara, $8,400, off to a really strong start to the season. Eagles defense a little bit shaky to start off the year, so definitely do like his upside once again. Jordan Mason, $8,300, so he is a lot more expensive on FanDuel. But he's been getting the opportunities, he's been getting the touches, he's been very effective. And this Rams team, very young on that defensive line and linebacker unit, so there is upside to be had there at the same time as well. We got Jonathan Taylor, $8,000. He is kind of off to a slow start to the season, but going against the Bears could be a little bit of upside to be had there just in general. Derrick Henry, $7,800. Probably another guy that's off to a little bit slower start to the season than we like, but Dallas Cowboys really struggling against the run so far to start off the year. Derrick Henry does offer a good amount of upside in that matchup. Then we move down to Devon Achane at $7,700 going against the Seattle Seahawks. Struggled against the run last year. Achane is kind of the lead back now, especially with Raheem Mostert doubtful. We'll see if anybody else gets worked in, but Achane has kind of been that workhorse role and does offer quite a bit of upside in that role. Then we get moved down to Josh Jacobs. Really relied on him last week. Probably could play him on DraftKings as well. I didn't really mention him over there, but $7,300. Don't mind that price tag on FanDuel going against the Tennessee Titans. You know, that defensive line of the Titans, they have some big bodies there. Obviously, Jeffrey Simmons is a very good player, but the other guys around him, still relatively young and improving. So if Green Bay can run the ball effectively, once again, Josh Jacobs is going to look really good. Then we have J.K. Dobbins up to $7,200 going against the Steelers. Not quite as good of a matchup as he's had in recent weeks, but definitely do like his upside once again, as he's been showing that he can even break off a long play on any given run, even coming off an Achilles injury. So that is pretty impressive, just to say the least. Then we move down to Zach Charbonnet, $6,700 going against the Miami Dolphins. Do expect Kenneth Walker to miss once again this week, so he is going to be kind of the bell cow for them. Wasn't the greatest last week, but still did put up a decent fantasy point performance. And then we have DeAndre Swift, $6,300. Off to a slow start this year, but the Colts did really struggle against the run last week versus the Packers. And Travis Homer's out, so he could see some third down usage as well. Chuba Hubbard, $5,800, going against the Las Vegas Raiders. A little bit of upside to be had there, kind of that main back for them once again this season. Carson Steele I have here at $5,200. If you want to play like any specific Kansas City running back, you would probably do it. They're all kind of dart throws this week overall, but I know Carson Steele is probably going to be the favorite around the goal line. Maybe if Kareem Hunt's active, he could be as well. And then last but not least, we have min price tag Cam Akers, $4,000. There is no Joe Mixon. There is no Damian Pierce this week. He should be the lead back for this Texans team. Obviously, we'll see what it looks like as that game plays out, but would expect that he is pretty popular on both sides this week overall. Then we get moved over to the wide receiver position. We got CeeDee Lamb at the top, $9,300. You know, going against the Baltimore Ravens, a little bit of a tougher matchup, but still do like CeeDee Lamb just in general. Amon-Ra St. Brown, $9,100. Going against the Arizona Cardinals, Garrett Williams in the slot. Does look like a really favorable matchup for him. Obviously, you can stack him with Jared Goff. Kind of talked about that on DraftKings. Talked a little bit about it on FanDuel as well. Mike Evans, $8,300. Probably getting to him a little less on FanDuel. Really strong start to the season, but you're going to see some Patrick Surtain the second in this game. Most players don't really slow down Mike Evans too much, so I'm not super, super concerned about it. Maybe a decent leverage play. We'll ultimately see what his ownership comes in at, though. And then we have Devonta Smith, $8,000, going against the New Orleans Saints. No A.J. Brown once again this week. He'll be their number one wide receiver for them. Is a tougher matchup going against Marshawn Lattimore and Paulson Adebo just in general, though. Nico Collins, $7,600. He's off to a really strong start to the season. Goes against the Minnesota Vikings. Decent upside there. You can play him. You can play Stephon Diggs. You can play Tank Dell. All are very reasonable prices on this slate, and all do offer pretty good upside just in general. Marvin Harrison Jr., $7,500. Going against the Detroit Lions. Not really worried about the matchup against Tyrion Arnold or Carlton Davis. Just kind of depends on what side he lines up on more. Tyrion Arnold is dealing with an illness. Carlton Davis, you know, probably not as good as he once was. I was never the biggest believer in him just in general, but he is a little bit overrated at this point in time. I believe there's truly a reason the Buccaneers did get rid of him. So do like the upside of Marvin Harrison Jr. Do expect him to be relatively popular on this slate overall. Then we got Chris Godwin, $6,600, going against the Denver Broncos. Jaquan McMillan in the slot. He's a little bit banged up now, so if it's not him, it could be somebody even worse. We'll definitely favor Chris Godwin just in general. DJ Moore, I like the upside versus the Indianapolis Colts, $6,500. Not a bad price tag on DraftKings. Then we have Brandon Ayuk, $6,500. Most likely no Debo Samuel this week, so going to be a pretty attractive one there. Going against the Rams should be pretty attractive just in general. If you want to play Brandon Ayuk on DraftKings, definitely go ahead and do it. And then we move down to Drake London, $6,400. Going against the Kansas City Chiefs, this is the Sunday night game. Don't mind that matchup for him just in general. If he scores a touchdown, he could be pretty good overall. Rashid Shaheed, $6,300. He's going against the Philadelphia Eagles, off to a really strong start to the year. Goes against Avante Maddox in the slot. Should be a really attractive matchup for him as well. Then we move down to DeMarcus Robinson, $6,100. Maybe a little bit more than I like to pay. It's not the greatest matchup versus the 49ers, but there is no Cooper Kupp. There's no Puka Nacua, so he should be the number one wide receiver for them this week overall. And then we move down to Jalen Naylor. Coming off back-to-back weeks with a touchdown, $5,900 going against the Texans. Justin Jefferson should see most of Derek Slingley. So Jalen Naylor does have a little bit of upside in this game just in general. And apparently he does have pretty decent chemistry with Sam Darnold. Then we have DeAndre Hopkins, $5,400. Limited through 2 weeks, but going against the Packers this week overall. If it's Eric Stokes on him, should be a pretty interesting matchup. If it's Jair Alexander, it could be a little bit tougher. But at this price tag, why not take a shot? Same thing could be said with Cortland Sutton at $5,300 going against Tampa Bay Buccaneers, who do have a relatively young and banged up secondary at this point in time. Deontay Johnson's also $5,300. Do think with Andy Dalton starting and a good matchup versus the Raiders, should be a pretty decent week for him overall. Then we move over to the tight end position. We got Travis Kelce. This is a Sunday night game going against the Atlanta Falcons, $7,200. Off to a slow start this year, but I think it's a good buy low spot for him just in general. Not really too worried about those Falcons linebackers if they're trying to cover him. You know, if it's one of the safeties, might be a little bit tougher matchup, but do like his upside just in general. Got George Kittle, $7,100. Going against the Rams, going against those young, kind of unproven linebackers just in general. I know Troy Reader's not that young, but him and Rosenbaum, you know, relatively unproven at this point in time. So definitely do like his upside. And then with the potential of no Debo Samuel in this game, makes him look even better. Then there's Sam Laporta, $7,000. Off to a slow start to the year, but do like the upside versus this Arizona Cardinals team just in general. Trey McBride, $6,000. Going against the Detroit Lions. Alex Elizone, a little bit banged up at this point in time. Do like the upside that does come with Trey McBride at $6,800. Brock Bowers, $6,300. Going against the Panthers. Should be a decent matchup. Coming off a really strong performance, so I definitely like him once again. Missing a couple matchups here, so I do apologize for that. But Colby Parkinson, $5,300. Goes against the San Francisco 49ers. A little bit tougher matchup, but especially with Dre Greenlaw, their better coverage linebacker on IR, maybe not as bad as you think. Plus, there's no Cooper Kupp or Puka Nacua, so additional targets to go around for this Rams team just in general. Luke Schoonmaker, $4,900, coming off a pretty strong performance in the absence of Jake Ferguson, so like him a little bit once again. Jordan Akins, kind of like we talked about in DraftKings, no David Njoku, so he will get most of the snaps at tight end for them this week. Although he's kind of one of those guys, when you think you can count him, really doesn't pay off, so kind of play at your own risk there at that point in time. And then last but not least, we get moved over to the defenses. We got the Browns, $4,900 going against the Giants. If they can get pressure on Daniel Jones, going to be a good week for them overall once again. Tampa Bay Buccaneers, $4,700 going after Bo Nix at quarterback. Not the greatest start to the season, not the greatest start to the career for Bo Nix just in general. Plus, right tackle Mike McGlinchey's out this week. If they can get that pressure on him, should be pretty good overall. Seattle Seahawks, $4,600, and they're going against the Miami Dolphins backup quarterback Skylar Thompson getting the start. Probably not a team that I'm getting too much. I kind of talked about that on DraftKings as well, but there is some upside to be had there, and I definitely do see it. And then we have the Packers at $4,000 going against the Tennessee Titans. If they can get after Will Levis, should be a pretty good game for them overall, coming off a really strong performance versus the Indianapolis Colts and Anthony Richardson just in general. And then we have the Los Angeles Chargers, $3,900, strong start to the season. And they're going against the Pittsburgh Steelers. Do expect Justin Fields gets the start at quarterback once again. That offensive line is pretty banged up. So I definitely do like the upside of this Chargers team once again overall. And then last but not least, we have the Tennessee Titans, $3,700, going against the Green Bay Packers. If anyone knows Malik Willis well, his strengths and weaknesses, probably the Tennessee Titans. So they're going to find a way to get after him and kind of put him in uncomfortable situations just in general. And if they can do that, should be some opportunities for turnovers and everything else like that. But with that being said, that's what I do have in terms of my player pool for week number 3 for both DraftKings and FanDuel. As always, if you have any questions related to NFL DFS for week number 3, be sure to drop them down in the comment section of this video and I'll get back to you as quickly as possible. And then with that being said, if there's any other major news, I'll leave that down in the comment section of this video. My player pool sheet will be up on my Patreon page. It will be constantly updated over the weekend. So feel free to take a look over there if you guys have any other specific in-depth questions. Once again, feel free to drop them down in the comment section of this video. If you're over on Patreon, feel free to message me over there as well. I would be more than happy to help each and every one of you as best as possible. But with that being said, if you are brand new to my channel, checking out for the very first time, or have yet to subscribe, please consider doing so. Definitely would appreciate it. Helps to build the community that we're trying to build here at Coach Craig Sports, which is one that's truly for you, the viewers, helping you with your DFS. Right now, we have my NFL DFS video coming out once a week. Probably going to be coming out either on Friday or Saturdays. Obviously, might change week to week just a little bit here and there. So hopefully you guys are pretty flexible with that. Hopefully you guys all enjoy this NFL DFS player pool video that I'm putting out. If you have any other type of suggestions or anything else like that, feel free to drop that down in the comments as well. And then my CFL DFS video drops once a week, typically on Thursdays, although some weeks it might come out on Wednesday. Just kind of depends on what all I got going on that specific week. So definitely on the lookout for that as well. And then once again, be sure to check out the Patreon page, patreon.com/CoachKirkSport. Get a lot of good content for both CFL and NFL DFS, as well as access to my fantasy football rankings, my matchup sheet, my snap count spreadsheets, everything else like that. Very small monthly donation over there for the amount of information that you do ultimately end up getting. And then last but not least, if you're interested in sports betting, if you're interested in prop betting whatsoever, be sure to check out the links and promo codes down in the description below for BetUS, Parlay Play, and Prize Picks. If you're a brand new user on any one of those three sites, when you sign up, make your initial deposit, you'll get a first match deposit bonus. For Prize Picks and Parlay Play, it's 100% match up to $100. And then for BetUS, it's 125% match up to $2,000. So some pretty great opportunities to be had out there. If you have any other additional questions related to that whatsoever, feel free to reach out to me, whether it's down in the comment section of this video or on Twitter at Coach Craig Sport, and be more than happy to help you with that journey as well. But with that being said, that's all that I truly have for this week's video. Definitely do appreciate each and every one of you tuning in. Definitely means a lot to me. I hope that each and every one of you have a great rest of your day, no matter what day you're watching this on, a good weekend overall, and some really good luck in NFL DFS for week number 3.